Okay guys, round 8 is about to go down, and at the time I'm recording this, which is about 1:45 in the morning, day 2 of the EUWCQ is probably about to start in like 3 hours, so I don't know. I really should be going to bed, but I really want to watch this match because Joshua Schmidt is playing White Forest Runic, hell yeah, against Benjamin G on regular Runic, Runic Stun, using Runic for evil and not for good. Goes for the Pot of Duality to search for the Rivalry of Warlords and has Imano Iwato in hand. So we're going to have to see if White Force Runic can break through the Runic Stun. And I would say against Runic Stun, if you're going to play against Runic Stun, having Runic cards your own yourself is going to be pretty good. Let's see. Benjamin flips the Skill Drain, pays 1,000 life for that to stop the Sylvie of the White Forest from, I think that one searches the Spell or Trap card, and then we have a Flashing Fire here to summon a Freki. Okay, so yeah, we got Freki coming out. Let's see if Josh has something to clear that Freki. We can still get some battle damage in if we activate the Runic spell in the battle phase, but oh my gosh, he starts with Fountain plus Tip. That is insane. So we also know there's a Rivalry of Warlords set. So Tip is going to search. Is that Destruction there? We know we're going to be able to out the Skill Drain or the Rivalry of Warlords, whichever one we want. But that is the beautiful thing about playing Runix yourself, is you can just play the outs to these Floodgates in your main deck. So let's see if Josh can take over. He has, that's the Flashing Fire there. Vanishes a Tip off the top. Plus the D Fissure, so that's going to be pretty strong. Fountain puts back. We're going to draw two here. Oh, I guess Freki added back, and then that played into Talents. So Josh is going to draw two more with Talents. Holy dude, he is setting up. What is that? Is that Freezing Curses or whatever? Okay, we're going to chain Destruction on the Rivalry of Warlords just to get some more monsters out, not caring about the Skill Drain. There's Jerry. Also, we banished a second Tip off of Benjamin's side, plus the Card of Demise, so that's pretty clutch. We go into the big, the level 8 Whitewood Synchro, which is going to have its effects negated on the field with Skill Drain, but still a good body to have on board. Let's see. Benjamin draws for turn. Also, they're wearing matching hats. Is that on purpose? Normal summon a Mono Iwato, which is going to stay because it's not going to bounce because of Skill Drain. There's Tip by Josh. Tip is going to search. That's Destruction. Banishes a Fountain off the top with Tip. That is huge for Josh. And then we're going to put three back, draw three with Fountain. This game is so in Josh's hands, it's not funny. There's Destruction on the Skill Drain. I think this is still on Benjamin's turn. Hold on, what did he banish? Just three Runic spells and a D Fissure. That's pretty clutch. Amano Iwato is going to go back to hand, I think, if this is end phase. Oh, Benjamin scoops it up. Scooping it up early. Okay, Whitewood's Runic taking a quick one off of Runic Stun. Josh has got to be feeling really good right now, because I'm sure he doesn't want to be playing against Runic. Or maybe he does want to be playing against Runic Stun since his matchup is so good. But moving on to game two here. We're probably going to see Runic Stun go first. Alright. Normal summon border, set three, Card of Demise. Oh my god, for a Judgment and a Tip. Get out. Guy opened the stones. Okay, banishes the White Wood, the White Forest trap card off the top, searches Fountain, sets two, pass. What a legend. Evenly matched, met by Judgment. That's tough, dude. Can you imagine if there was no Judgment? Dude would have just got cooked immediately. That's awesome. I wonder if you ever just wait to like use another evenly match, like don't put any monsters on board. Maybe that's what Josh's plan is. Like, do you even activate Fountain, or do you just hope to get another evenly here? Okay, there's Fountain. But, like, you wouldn't even want to activate the runic spells. You would just want to, you need to have your battle phase available to you, obviously. But I guess we're just going for actual runic plays here. Summon out Hugin. We're going to go Fountain 1, Hugin 2, pitch the second Slumber. Pretty strong. So we're at least going to be able to search out another Fountain here. And then probably draw 2. Yeah, because Fountain targets, right? So we can't shuffle that discarded Slumber up back. Okay, also Benjamin's down to 4k life, so if Josh can put up some monsters on board somehow and start swinging over, watch out, you know what I mean? Like, if we can set up a Chenying or something, a Chenying's got to be huge in this matchup, because there's another tip. He drew two tips in a Judgment. That was the other card he set off of the card of Demise. He drew Judgment plus two tips. Holy, he's got three cards in hand right now, draws a fourth. I know one's a trap card there. Josh also has six cards in hand or whatever. Oh, that's the card trader variant. I forget what it's called exactly. Card scanner. Okay, so they reveal the bottom card, call a type, they're gonna call spell. If they both have a spell, they both add it. Which, they're both going to have a spell, obviously, because Josh is putting cards to the bottom, the runic cards. But unfortunately, he put Slumber on the bottom and not Tip. That would have been huge for Josh. Banishes a Flashing off the top. Okay. Activate Freezing. Activate Flashing. Activate Slumber. Okay. Banish 3. Banish 3 for Josh as well. One of those is Destruction. So I guess one was a Pop and one was a Negate on the Hugin. Okay. That's all pretty good. There's Pot of Duality for 3. Gets Gozen, TC Boo, and Tip. Dude just keeps finding all the runic tips, dude. That'll be the third one this game. Which is insane. There's Flashing onto the Hugin, but it's negated, or it's not negated, but Hugin can't be destroyed because of Slumber. Why do we even activate that? Did we forget? Okay, there's one of the Whitewoods cards. Is that Sylvie again? No, that's Rusha. Rivalry? Okay, are we gonna, do we have a Destruction? No, we're just gonna send that away. We do have a Fountain. That's pretty good. I mean, this game is not out of reach. I don't know how we're gonna get through with the Rivalry though. But Josh decided to keep the Hugin. Which means we have a way to play at least. Smiting Storm, this is just an activation. It will banish 5 off of Benjamin's field. I mean, deck. Okay, chain Tip. Why are we chaining Tip? That'll banish 6 off his deck. Chain Freezing Curses onto the border. Chain Flashing Fire onto the Hugin. Okay, banishes 2. Then Benjamin banishes 3 for the Freezing. And then they're going to search. And now they're going to banish 7 off of the Smiting Storm. That's a lot of cards off Benjamin. I wonder who's banishing more. Gets rid of the Desires, which is unfortunate for Josh. Like, I would want Benjamin to have Desires. Like, sure, banish 10 more cards, dude. Okay, puts back 3 with Fountain. Okay, Destruction, banish 4 off of Josh. This is looking a little tough. Josh is down to 2 cards in hand or something. Benjamin's up to like 6 cards in hand. Yeah, this is getting a little out of control. Do you scoop? Duality for another tip. Duality for tip is like getting annoying. It's like every time he's duality, he's hit a runic tip. Josh is running out of cards. Hugin should have gone back. Okay. Yeah. Benjamin keeps activating Fountain. I'm assuming that we keep passing turn. And I'm not noticing. That evenly would have been nice. But maybe Ben has Skill Drain. I mean, Solemn Judgment set again. I wonder how many of those we're playing. But I haven't seen him banish any. There's another evenly. There's the Judgment. That's tough. I think that was Josh's last attempt to enter this game. There's another tip again. Banish a tip off of the Josh's deck. That's tough. Draw two. Benjamin has like seven cards in hand. Okay. I think Benjamin used card trader or whatever. Calling like monster or trap. Putting a runic spell to the top of Josh's deck so that he would banish it. That would be neat. But I guess that's not what happened. I don't know. Josh has like six or seven cards left in deck. But like Benjamin does too, right? Slumber, slumber on Inspector Border. Oh man, this is tough. Like Josh can't even play a card. Like if he plays a spell or trap, chain runic destruction, banish the rest. This is GG. Josh has one card in the deck. Benjamin activate a tip and it's over. Benjamin has so many cards in hand, he has got a discard. Ash Blossom, that would have been nice earlier. Okay. Josh, I think you got a scoop. Save your time, buddy. But I guess time is almost in his favor. Like, Benjamin pays all of his life points. If it goes into time, Benjamin's struggling more than Josh is. So, I'm not really sure what's going on right now. Time is in Josh's favor. But Benjamin's not making any plays. There's tip. Oh, he can't activate tip because Benjamin has one card left in deck. And it's not a runic card. Or it's a tip. Wait, does Ben really have one card in deck? Can Josh activate anything to banish a card? Are you serious? They're going to run out of cards at the same time? Oh my gosh, dude. Bro, if Josh just had a runic... No, a runic tip wouldn't have even done it because he can't surge. Jeez, Josh lost by one card of banishing. You hate to see that. Alright, Josh goes first. No, did he just pass turn? Oh, jeez, Josh. You passed turn. What is your hand looking like? Hugin discard Pot of Desires. Yeah, Benjamin probably does not want to activate Pot of Desires anytime soon because he knows deck out is also Josh's win condition. There's Fountain searched by Hugin. Set one pass. That's pretty relatively weak end board. Does Josh have like evenly? We're not seeing like any White Woods play whatsoever this game. This is Runic versus Runic, but Benjamin has better Runic cards. Okay, destroy, banish, banish two. Talents, oh, because Hugin shuffled back. The Talents is live. Josh draws two more. Pass his turn. I mean, I guess, like, you're not gonna get attacked. But like, eventually you gotta start doing stuff. There's the Munin. Munin's gonna start gaining life. Ash on the Fountain to stop the draw two. That's pretty good. Desires for tip. That's also pretty good. Tip, search. Josh is like annoyed that he keeps finding runic tip. Banishes one of the white woods off the top. Fountain for three. Resolves. Slumber for whatever, three. Just slumber on Munin. Munin effect gains 1,000 life. Josh has another Ash Blossom in hand now. Oh, there's evenly matched. Okay. Finally, evenly resolves. Josh didn't use his battle phase. I mean, any runic cards. Summons out the... which one is that? Sylvie? I think the one to search a spell. He's going to get hit with freezing. Okay, we can... oh, we have the other... we have the extender. Bro, I want to see some Whitewoods play. This is just a runic versus runic. That one is flashing on the new guy. That's flashing also to summon. And then Hugin protects. Got it. Or does it? No, he's not going to protect. He's just going to summon. He's going to summon and let it banish too. Hugin effect discard. Discard to search fountain, and then Benjamin activates fountain for three, and Josh ashes the fountain for three. That's pretty good. But what does Josh have left in hand? He just has fountain in hand? Or did he just use his, the rest of his hand? Oh, man. Okay, Synchro for Tri-Edge Master to draw one. YOLO draw. There's Fountain that we saw earlier, plus a Freezing Curses. Chain Destruction on the Fountain. That's tough. Freezing Curses summons Jerry. Jerry back the Fountain. Jerry plus Tri-Edge is a level 10 Synchro. Chaos Angel banishes a Fountain. That's huge. That's one Fountain gone. One out of two. All we have to do is hit Benjamin's other fountain with a random runic banish. And we are cooking on Josh's side. Card shuffler, whatever. Oh, Josh misses the spell. Hits a monster. That's tough. Benjamin has two runics set, I'm imagining. What the heck just happened? We pitched fountain for Elzette. Searches the other guy, summons out, that's freezing on the other guy. Banish three off the top, two are evenly. Those are great banishes. Like, get those evenlies out of here because Josh has a board now. He's just got to start doing damage. I feel like you got to keep the Chaos Angel to do max damage, right? No, why are we linking that? SP banish that, really? I don't know. I don't like getting rid of that Chaos Angel. Destruction for Hugin. Searching Fountain. Oh, Hugin pitched D Shifter for Fountain. Oh, Benjamin's on Shifter. That's kind of interesting. Tip for... what is that? Destruction. Because now he knows Benjamin has a fountain. So getting that destruction ready to grow. So if you're going to fountain, you need to have like another... you need to have like two runics. One to protect and one to activate. Set two. All right, we got to start swinging, buddy. Swinging for the damage. Oh, man. I wish we didn't get rid of that Chaos Angel. But I guess we had to get rid of that card, Trader. Okay, there is another Elzette, right? And TC Boo is activated. Okay, just keep the biggest ones. At this point, like, TC Boo is okay. 53, I think he's on like a 2 more turn clock or 3 more turn clock. Those are huge differences. If it's 2 or 3 turns for this damn runic deck. There's Fountain. Passes turn to Josh. Josh attack, attack. Like, Josh really can't use any runic spells. Tip. Tips pretty good. That one is flashing. Flashing, target SP, Shane SP. Why not Shane SP? Slumber on SP. Okay, fair. Banishes a tip off the top. Fountain, put three back. Destruction, chain, freezing for Hugin to protect. So Benjamin draws three cards anyway. Summon a Mono Iwato. Set one, bounce back a Mono Iwato. Josh can't attack though. Oh, this would be game. Well, I mean, you had to use them, right? You had to use the runic spell. That's a tip. Oh, this is getting out of hand quickly. Wow, Josh has like five cards left in deck. Ooh, that's not good. Oh, he's so close to winning this game. Slumber, he has to slumber. Why did he slumber? It doesn't matter, he's gonna banish the whole deck. Oh no. Oh dude, I hate this Runic Stun deck. Get it out. Oh, it's just so lame to watch, dude. It's so lame to watch. Josh over here cooking on Whitewood's Runic gets taken down by a Runic Stun. Oh, you hate to see that, dude. I hate to see that. I don't know about you guys, but that's awful. No better way to put it. Kind of awful. Alright, well, that's going to wrap it up for this one. I wanted to see some Whitewoods play. But we just saw Runic versus Runic. With, like, Whitewoods cards used as discards. So, that was whatever. But, hope you enjoyed that one, I guess. We'll catch you guys in the next one. We'll see you soon.